Hello, my friends. Today I'm going to give you my top 5 things that I am freakishly, awesomely hyped about in 510 Jedi Under Siege. Let's talk about it! Hello, my friends. Boomy here once again with another video for you, my Swtor brothers and sisters. And if this is your first time here on the channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button for all the latest Swtor news from your bearded Bioware influencer and perhaps God. Boomy, my friends, how the hell is everyone doing today? I hope everyone is doing great. So we have 5.10 Jedi Under Siege coming very soon. I know. It's like, it's in December, man. Yeah, but if you think about it, we're already midway into October and time flies. Oh, it does. So December will be here way before we know it. I mean, hello, we have 68 days till Christmas. Hello. It's coming, baby. So I wanted to kind of just give you my top 5 things that I am hyped about that I really think are cool in 5.10. It's Jedi Under Siege. And then, of course, put your comments in the comment section below. Let me know what things you're most hyped about in this as well. So let's get to my very first one. Of course, it's companions. Ooh, we've been waiting for one of these, two of these. I've been waiting for two of these since, you know, we lost our companions with the Eternal Empire stuff. But, yeah, we're getting them back. Finally, Jason Williams is on her way back. We've been teased that we'd be getting her back sometime back in July. But that never actually happened, which was sad. And I had to calm a lot of people down on in the community about said thing, especially here on the channel, because reasons. But she's coming back, and so is Lightside Jaysa. And we're going to be able to romance or start the fling with Lightside Jaysa. So that's good. Looks like she took the purity ring off, so you guys might be able to have a little Lightside fun. Which, actually, if you think about it, doesn't sound fun at all. Yeah. No. No 50 shades with that one. So, we also, like I said, Darkside Jace is coming back into my world. That girl's got a lot of explaining to do about where the hell she has been and why on Earth she can feel everyone else in the universe except for me, her lover, her husband. Or, yeah, or wife. I mean, they're changing that up to where these can, you can have, like, you know, female on female, male on male relationships. So, I mean, that's cool. I mean, I don't care. I mean, that's awesome. And then we also have Nadia coming back. Oh, I love Nadia. I would actually marry her in real life. I would. She's like one of those, like, quiet type people that, you know, they're a total freak in the bedchamber just saying, I better keep going before I get, like, you know, strikes against my account. Then we have Kem Val coming back, and I guess you can romance him, but that's just outside of my ew. And Doc, of course, is coming back as well. I'm excited these companions are coming back. Of course, we all, I know, Kira. She'll be back, I promise you. I'm pretty sure she'll be back for 6.0. Or she'll be back later down with patch 5.11. I truly hope not, but, you know, I hope this is 6.0 after 5.10. That's what I want. Give it to me now. So what other things out there, you know, excites me and gets me going? Well, here's my second one. That's right, the new story arc that we are getting with 5.10 Jedi Under Siege, which will lead us into the new expansion for 6.0 and get us the hell out of whatever travesty we've been into the last couple years. So now we're finally going back into, you know, Republic versus Sith Empire, which is, you know, where it should be. And that is good, and it seems like they're doing it the correct way and getting things going. And this is why I have giant faith in Keith, who has had to deal with the last story arc that we had to get through. And they just kind of seem like, okay, let's just get through it, do all the things so we can get out of it. And now we are finally out of it, and we will be going into this brand new storyline, this new story arc, getting us back to what this game was founded on, but also probably with some twists here and there, for which they said that there will be more twists here and there. That's why they're not going to put the actual story content on the PTS itself. They want us to experience it. So I see a lot of surprises and kind of like, what? They did what? What happened? Oh my goodness, why? And for some mysterious figures to come back, for which I'm pretty sure I know who they are going to be. But maybe we'll save that for another video. But I am excited about this to see what's going on, what the story's going to be about, and how everything's going to dovetail in together with themselves. Of course, you have Melora coming back. You have Nostral making his very first in-game appearance in the game, and plus new characters as well that we will get to meet and fight beside. Now, when it comes to new things, new characters, like I was talking to a friend of mine earlier today about how the story is not just the characters in it, but the story itself is also a character. And that is why I'm a big fan of what's going to be going on Ossus. We get that brand new planet. That is correct. A brand new planet in this thing. It's not going to be anything like Campero or Umbara, thank goodness, because those are two planets I really wish we would, Swtor would have allowed us to investigate more and have more on rather than some silly little flashpoints. I kind of feel like they did themselves a disservice there. But however, on Ossus, and I'm glad to report, and as many of you might already know, because I have reported on it before, we will be doing dailies on here, and that is one of the other things that really excites me about 5.10. It's because, it's not just because dailies, because I love doing dailies, I know I'm weird, but it's also because dailies are there to let us know that this is not going to be a one and out, you know, type of content, but it's going to be continued content. We continue to do dailies and find new things here and there and get new decos and all that crap and everything. And I'm sure there's more Easter eggs and story on this planet than we are aware of. So we're going to be there for a little bit outside of a just wham, bam, thank you, ma'am, give me all the loot, I'm out, and I have nothing to do. So we actually have some content, and I think it's going to be a good amount of content for us to do outside of, you know, doing nightmare mode or master mode, sorry, with the gods of the machine out there. But yeah, Ossus is, I'm excited to explore Ossus and, you know, other sundry things like that. Now, another thing that I'm really excited about with 5.10 Jedi Under Siege is that we will be ungated. Unlike any last ones where, you know, to get your new companions back or to do whatever, you have to actually complete some of the flashpoints. You have to complete all the chapters up to the very end to get them. In this one, no, you just have to be level 70, which means you would have had to have subscribed at one point. But if you are 70, you can go straight into the 5.10 content, which is, you know, the sign to me that we're getting ready for 6.0 and they're getting the hell out of Coffee and Kotet. And that is good. And I'm glad they're doing this to ungate things, because the last thing you want to do is have gated content in a game for, you know, a good size of the community who doesn't subscribe regularly and who is already dealing with the gated aspects of free to play. So being able to get in there and not being heavy laden and heavy burdened is an awesome and good thing. And if you are new and if you are just getting in there and you wanted to sub for 1 month, party on, go that, hit that token for level 70, or you can get the Master's Datacron for level 70 and do all the story and romance everyone you need to romance before 5.10 gets here. So that's a thing you guys can do. Now, I have some bonus clips here for you from one of our influencers who found it on Ossus. Now here it is. You see the big smiley face there with the Ossus on it as well. This is a good above type scene right here. And I just think it's fun when you see devs have a little fun inside the PTS and, you know, have enough time, especially to draw a smiley face, which I think was awesome. And I really kind of hope they keep that there. That'd be awesome for them to keep there. What a great little Easter egg. I love it when companies do that. It shows that they have a sense of humor, which for which we know the dev team does. If you saw anything of the last live stream, they were a little bit all over the place. I think everyone was taking Eric Muskell's cold medicine at the time. Now, here is the other image inside that, you know, you have every once in a while situations where not all the key art or all the information has yet been given or written down, especially for achievements or for lore or for what that need. They have to have placeholders. So this is what I thought was a very interesting and funny placeholder. So as you'll see, there's a new name, the Yazana, who are there, but very interesting force capable people. as you can see, blah, blah, force sensitive, blah. So I honestly kind of hope they keep that here too. That would be awesome because, I don't know, they can call it the blah achievement. It'd be great. I would be totally on board with all of that. So my friends, those are the things I'm excited about, plus a little bonus material right there. Put your comments in the comment section below. What are you most excited about with 5.10 Jedi Under Siege, which is coming fairly soon. We don't have an exact date yet in December, but we do know it is coming fairly soon. So put your comments in the comment section below. Hit that like button because it helps the channel a heck of a lot. And hit that subscribe button, of course. Become part of the Boomy Nation family, the freak show of YouTube, the black sheep of gaming. And if you want to support me on a more personal level, make sure you hit the Patreon, to where you get all kinds of cool little things here and there. And a subscriber or Patreon podcast controlled by you, the Patreon. My friends, have a good one. Remember to be kind. It's about community. And we'll see you later. Good day.